The Spencer Mansion has a very specific look to it. It's archaic, stylized, ornate. But it's also a very specific style, from a specific point in history, that says a lot about the mansion's owners, and the message the game is trying to convey. This is a Victorian mansion, in both style and design. The Victorian period of British history marks the years 1837 to 1901, the reign of Queen Victoria, for whom it was named. It was the peak of British colonialism, a golden age of increased wealth and productivity, partially driven by the beginning of industrialization. Trains were spread throughout the country, allowing the quick and affordable transport of resources vital to architecture. Suddenly, it was far more affordable to design and build homes with intricate appearances and unique materials, and the Victorian style of architecture was born. Victorian architecture is ultimately about the appearance of wealth and splendor. It was a design meant to impress and give the appearance of status and class. There are basic features that tend to appear in most Victorian homes. They were 2 to 3 stories, with a wood or stone exterior. The roof was steep and multifaceted to create an intriguing outer appearance. They were complicated in design and asymmetrical in shape, with unique and rambling floor plans that were well known for being overly complex. Rooms had high ceilings with ornate chandeliers and elaborate wallpapers, often with floral designs, with fancy trim running the walls alongside carved and painted moldings and gilded wainscoting. Staircases were elaborate and used as focal points. Large windows and stained glass were very popular, as were the inclusion of balconies, towers, and turrets. There were certain areas of the house designed for entertaining and others for living. There was often a billiards room, a dining room, a sitting room, a library, and many more stylized rooms meant to show off the owner's wealth. Furniture styles varied and were often drawn from multiple influences from the past and the East and West. Typically, the owner had statues, artwork, unique furniture, decorative plant life, tapestries, and draperies. These were an important part of the design. Homes were decorated in what is called the Victorian decorative arts, a way of designing meant to once again display wealth and power. Rooms were intricately decorated and stuffed full of belongings. Walls were covered in artwork, crammed corner to corner with ornamentation. Rugs, chandeliers, furniture, shelving, books, artwork, statues. Every corner of the home was decorated with something that helped show how well off the owner was, how classy and intellectual they were because they owned these things. Artwork was huge, specifically older European paintings from previous centuries. These belongings were often from different times, cultures, and styles, and balancing the eclectic mix of influences was part of the Victorian decorative arts. The style appeared opulent and fancy, when in reality, because of automation and industrialization, these materials were cheaper than ever to make and ship. These homes were ostentatious and overdone. Within a few centuries, this style and the rich, opulent class it represented would fall to the wayside as the British Golden Age ended. The Spencer Mansion falls into the same style as these older houses. Of course, in-game, the mansion was designed by George Trevor, who was asked to fashion the home in the style of the original Spencer Mansion that existed in Europe. Our first hint that this home is meant to reference a European, specifically British, mindset. Looking at the home, it clearly has all the markers. High ceilings and chandeliers, ornate wallpapers, and overly decorated halls. The artwork fits the pattern too. Not only are the pieces all European works, mostly from time periods before the Victorian period, nearly all of them are paintings of nobles and royals. There's the Arnolfini portrait, the wedding picture of a very rich merchant. The equestrian portrait of Charles I, a British king. three ladies adorning a term of hymen, the aforementioned women being the daughters of nobility, and Mr. and Mrs. William Hollett, the wedding photo of a noble family. Other famous images include King Lear weeping over the dead body of Cordelia, which depicts the tragic scene from the Shakespearean play, and Judith beheading Holofernes, a Caravaggio depiction of the biblical scene. Both are tragic and violent images. There's also a picture of a castle in one hallway. The castle is Neuschwanstein Castle in Germany. It was built by a king in the 19th century as a holiday retreat, and though he used his own funds to build the castle, he was well known for overspending. It's now a famous tourist site, and an example of the opulence and senseless spending of the upper class. When examined, the character in Resident Evil says the picture is of the mansion from outside, tying the mansion itself to Neuschwanstein Castle. Some of the art I haven't been able to identify. This painting in the main hall has a secret door in it leading to the backyard. On one side is a praying woman, the other a man holding a book, looking skyward. All in all, a very religious image. Between them is a gravestone, which opens up into the graveyard behind the mansion. Whatever the image is, it's clearly a fitting secret door for the area. There's more than just paintings. These plates are the same design as real-world blue and white Chinese porcelain. By the 17th century, China had an extensive porcelain trade with Europe, exporting cheaply made decorative pieces that looked like this, as well as vases and other porcelain works that were very popular in the Victorian period. The statues are Hellenistic, or Greek, in style. They're beautiful marble works with fabric folds that look real and are often partially or entirely nude. The Victorian era was a high point for sculpture and began with a revival of the Greek style. Of course, we have to mention the complex and asymmetrical layout of the mansion, which is a game design choice meant to create a more maze-like environment, but it is also exactly the type of house Victorians would design. Perhaps they wouldn't have had death traps and secret laboratories, but most of the Spencer Mansion is realistically in line with Victorian architecture and design. Resident Evil is the story of a group of very rich and powerful people acting without thought for the consequences. As the series unfolds, we see Umbrella acting much like the upper class of Victorian society, imagining themselves as superior, untouchable, spending money in ridiculous amounts, trying to appear to the public as having class. But much like the Victorian society that was built on imperialism and oppression, beneath the clean outer image is the dark truth of Umbrella. The Spencer Mansion tells us everything we need to know about the mansion's owners. They value the outer appearance, hiding their real intentions. This is also why the style of Victorian art and design continues from the first game. The police station in Resident Evil 2 is full of Victorian influences, and this is another scenario in which the rich and powerful are attempting to appear one way while hiding the dark truth. Even Resident Evil 4 pulls on some of these ideas, setting a great portion of its gameplay inside an ornate European castle. It's a subtle yet powerful way to reinforce the messages already present in the games, the depravity of the rich and powerful, and the lengths they go to appear a certain way.